Alright, so what is a solution means? A solution is a homogeneous mixture. I don't have to repeat in class 11 what is a homogeneous mixture. Okay, so it is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances whose concentration can be varied within certain limits. Okay, so this is the definition of solution, that it is a
present in the lesser quantity of the substance A
water and substance A. So the formula of mass percent, so we are finding the mass percent of A. So I'm going to write it here, the mass percent of A is equals to mass of solute. So solute is in the presence of the lesser quantity, that is A. So I'm going to write it here, mass of A divided by mass of A plus water, because that makes a solution. Substance A plus water, that makes a whole solution. So that's how I write it here, mass of A plus water into 100. Alright, so what is the mass of A? That is given to us, that is 2 divided by mass of A, that is 2 plus how much gram of water is present here? That is 18, yes, very good, into 100. Alright, when you calculate this, you pull 2 divided by 20 into 100. So what will you get? Only 10. So this is the 10% of A. Alright students, so then you don't have to write it here, 10%. So this is the mass percent. Please copy this. Now students, coming to the next concentration term, a very important, that is known as mole fraction denoted by X. Okay, what is the definition of this mole fraction? That it is the ratio of number of moles. It is the ratio of number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles of the solution. Suppose if we dissolve any substance, any component A in B. Okay, if we dissolve any component A in B, then the number of moles of A, how can we write the number of moles? By N, small. And if we are writing the number of moles of A, then we have to write it N. Okay, and the number of moles of B, that is N. Okay, and then we have to calculate the mole fraction of each and every component. Then what we have to do, it is denoted by, if you want to calculate the mole fraction of A, then we have to write in the form of XA. Okay, so XA is equals to, what is the definition of mole fraction? That it is the ratio, it is the ratio of numbers, it is the ratio of number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles. Where the particular component is A, so here I am going to write the number of moles of A divided by total number of moles of the solution. In the solution there A and B components are present, so here I am going to write N plus N. So this is the mole fraction of A. XA is equals to NA upon NA plus N. Same for the mole fraction of B. Hence we have calculated that XB is equals to NB divided by NA plus N. Okay, now the total mole fraction come out to be XA plus XB is equal to 1. Just remember this equation also. Very important equation. Alright, so this is all about the two concentration terms. In the next class, we are going to discuss the next two concentration terms that are very important, molarity and molarity. Just copy this, students. Thank you. Now, students, coming back to our new topic, and we have already discussed the two concentration terms in the previous class. That is known as the mass percentage and mole fraction with numerical. Now today I am going to discuss the last two terms in of your class 11 that are very very important. Please just keep your mind set. Alright, and just do the numericals as well as completed your topics. Okay, now today I am going to teach you the next two terms, that is known as molarity and molality. Okay. So here and molarity, which is defined by capital M. Remember this thing, molarity always defined by capital M. What it says that it is defined the number of moles of the solute. It is defined as the number of moles of the solute present in 1000 ml or 1 liter of the solution. 8 liter ya 1000 ml ne kitne number of moles of solute ke present hai, hum isse identify karte hai by the concentration term, that is known as molarity, denoted by capital M. Now the mathematical expression for molarity. esophagus, and then when we do with the pneumatic esophagus. Now, students, coming to the numerical of molarity, the question says that the calculate the molarity of NaOH in the solution prepared by dissolving 4 gram in enough water to form 250 ml of the solution. So, what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the molarity. Solution made from solute and solvent, which is present in the lesser quantity, that is known as solute. So, here the solute is NaOH, okay, which is present in 4 gram. Okay, and the solution is made up of 250 ml of water. So, what is the formula of molarity, students? Molarity is equals to number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liters. So, number of moles. So, how can we write this? N divided by V, and this is in liters. Alright, then elaborate this. This N becomes W upon M. So, this W means given mass divided by molar mass of solute. This is the given mass of solute and molar mass of solute. So this right hand side, solute is NaOH, alright, and the volume. Okay, now putting the values of in this equation, that what is the given mass of NaOH, that is 4 gram, which is right in the 4, alright. Then after the molar mass of NaOH, we easily calculate by adding the atomic masses of each and every element, that is like 23 plus 16 plus 1. You will get what? 40. So, 40 over here. Okay, the molar mass of NaOH is 40. And the volume. You see the volume here, we are talking about in the liters. But the volume is given to us in the question is in ml. So, to convert this ml into liters, what we have to do? We have to divide the 250 ml by 1000. So, when we divide 250 by 1000, what do we get? We get, this tends not to be either, that is we get 0.25 in liters. Alright, this ml is get converted into liters. Okay, now just put in the value, that is 0.25. Alright, what we get? Please do the calculation and you will get the molarity. Alright, so when you are finding the answer, just write the m as a unit. Alright, you can find the unit also, you can write it here. You can see this is mole and this is volume. So the unit comes out to be mole per liter. So you can write, or instead of molarity, you can easily write mole per liter. This is the unit of molarity, students. Okay, just copy this, just calculate the answer, just write it in your copy. Okay, so that we can proceed to the next and the last concentration term, that is known as molarity. Copy this. So now, students, coming to the last concentration term, that is known as molarity, which is defined by a small m. Student, this is very much important to note that those terms, that those contains volume, those are temperature dependent, and those who don't have any volume, they are dependent on the mass, they are independent on temperature. So the molarity is independent on temperature. Why is it so? Because it is the number of moles of solute present in 1000 grams or 1 kilogram of the solvent. Okay, here what we are talking about, that the number of moles of solute are dissolved, are present in 1 kilogram or 1000 grams of the solvent. So the mathematical expression can be written as that small m, that is defined as molality, is equal to number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kilogram. So now what we have to do, that number of moles is equals to given mass, we are given weight divided by molar mass of the solute. Now putting this, the value of n in this equation, that comes out to be W upon n dash, and the mass of solvent I am going to write it here by W dash. So the this is small W, this is the mass of the solute, and this is the mass of the solvent. So I am writing here W dash. Okay. Now this is in grams, so this is also in the, must be in grams. This is in kilograms. So when we are doing the calculation, we cannot give a right answer. Okay. Why this? So we have to convert this kilogram into grams. So what we have to do? We have to divide this W dash by 1000. After dividing, we are converting now just copy this and then we proceed to the numerical. Okay, copy this. Now, student, this is all about our chapter number one, or you can say our unit number one, some basic concepts of chemistry. I hope that you all understand the topics of each and every topic of your unit number one. I hope that you are all copying the notes, and please go through the videos. If you have any problem, just write in the comment box.